Welcome to Qt Widgets and More, the third episode in the series on developing Qt Designer plugins. In this episode, we'll see how to create your library out of your application. I'll tell you when, just after we had this intro. It is useful to make a library out of your application when you want to do one of two things. You want to unit test it, and you want to make a plugin for Qt Designer. The reason why you want to make a library is that very likely your data and your widgets are intermingled like spaghetti. It's not possible for you to create an instance of your widgets completely separate from the rest of the application. Let me give you an example. In KDAB Viewer, I have a very simple list selector, similar to the one that you've seen in the wishes in the previous episode. This list selector is just a bunch of checkboxes on top of each other, representing each of the region that KDAB is located in. Which region that is comes out of a database. So I have a data structure representing the regions, and my widget is connected to that data structure. It's impossible for me. Nothing is impossible. It would be hard for me to take these two apart. So instead, I simply take the whole KDAB viewer, make that into a library that I link, and my plugins load a whole KDAB viewer so that I can access those data structures. Of course, you can skip this whole video if you can make instances out of those widgets that you want to promote without your whole application. But when it comes to unit testing, which was the other thing, you might actually want to do this nevertheless. Let me show you what it looks like. So here's my image viewer that you saw a few episodes ago. It's a simple image viewer instance here, and my image viewer is a subclass of QWidget, and the user interface, you've seen this code already. Here's my UI file promoted widget, and that's just one thing in this that is different, namely this QWAM for QWidgets and More, lib_export, and the QWAM lib export macro up here. Let's just look at what this one does. And if you're on Linux, you might actually look at different code because this is an automatically generated file. But what it does is that it creates this QWAM lib export. That was the one we had down here. And if I am making a library, then it makes it to _decal_spec_dll_export. Otherwise, it makes it to _decal_spec_dll_import. What that means is that when I create my library, this is something that started on Windows, but Linux has it these days too. So when I create my library, I will not export all of the symbols from that library. And I do not do that for two reasons. It's the same thing as you don't make all your instance variable public. That's one of the reasons. And the other reason is that it's simply the fewer symbols, the faster it is to load. Wait. Auto-generated file you set. Who's setting that up? And where did that QWAM_lib_export, where did that name come from? Calm down, we'll get there. I'll show you a CMake file now. And the reason why I don't show you this as a project file with a QMake is simply that the second you start making libraries, CMake is just so much easier. So I'll actually give you a few links in the description below on how to do this with QMake. After a few hours of tinkering around with it, I simply gave up and said, CMake is so much easier for me. But you can look at that link if you really want to do it with QMake. I thought that day would never come where I would encourage people to use CMake and where I would even explain a CMake file. But hey, things happen, right? So what you're looking at here is the CMake file for this project here. And I'll not go into all the details. You can look that up yourself. But here is the short version of it. CMake minimum required version, go with version 3.3 or above, otherwise, whatever. The project is turn app into a lib, which is just the name of the project. Include generate export headers. That's the first one that is important here. This makes, it's just an include statement as include statements in C++. It simply finds this generate export header dot CMake, which is shipped together with CMake. I ask for at least C++ 11 and I say, I want it, not just a give me a compiler if you can, but I insist give me that compiler. AutoMock and AutoUIC makes it so nice to work with because I do not need to worry about anything about mock files or running the UIC. I simply set up my library here with these files in here. These two lines here is not strictly required, but if you develop on Linux and you deploy also on Windows, please do have these two lines in. What they do is that they give you the same behavior on Linux as you have on Windows, namely that the symbols are not exported unless explicit exported, the QAM underscore export macro. If you do not have that, then it will work on Linux because then all the symbols will be exported. That can be somewhat annoying for your coworkers when they cannot compile on Windows. I find the package here, I want Q5 and I want widgets, and it is really required. Now, I create a library. The library is called qamlib, so that's the library of qwidget and more here. It's a shared library, and these are the files that goes into that library. I call the generate export headers. That was a function that was in this class or whatever you call that CMake file up here that I included. So generate export headers qamlib, and that is what gives me this generated file that has this qamlib underscore export, and it goes into a file called qamlib underscore export.h. With that, I now say target link library. So I'll create a library here out of what I specified for that. And I need to link against Qt 5. And when it compiles these files, given that I'm a library, it will compile the qamlib export as the export macro. I also, from this CMake file, I'll compile both the library and a binary. And the binary, I have add executable here, and this is my binary. And if I go back to my main.cpp, you will notice that it looks exactly like what the main.cpp looked like before. Now, it's just the only thing that is in the binary, or the only file that is compiled for the binary, and then it link against this library. And my binary here is linked against this qamlib, and that's it. One thing though, if you ever want to deploy your binary somewhere else than in this current working directory, then if you're on Windows, you need to copy the lib qamlib or whatever it's called .dll file with it. Otherwise, half of the functionality is not there. That's it for this episode of Qt Widgets and More. I forgot to give you your homework in the previous episode. So go back if you haven't done so already. Adapt all your widgets that you want to make into plugins to use that new mechanism with that templarized base class that I showed you. And the homework for this episode is to actually make your library or your application into a library plus a binary and add that export macro to all of those. Or you might want to wait with that because it is slightly easier to have your compiler tell you, hey, you did not export this symbol, than it is to guess which one to export. But that's up to you. In the next episode, we'll start looking at how to create a plugin. Until then, stay safe and have fun.